Okay, guys, so spring is here and the flowers are blooming, and so I figured why not put some on my nails. And I've been seeing a lot of these going around lately, so I decided to give it a try, and this is what I came up with. So if you want to see how to do this, then just keep watching. So what I've done is painted my pinky nail and ring finger with a yellow polish. This is Sally Hansen Extreme Wear in Mellow Yellow. And then I painted my index, middle, and thumb with Sally Hansen Extreme Wear in Lacey Lilac. And I did have to do two coats and I think three coats with the yellow just to make sure it was opaque enough. And really, you don't have to use these same colors. You can use any colors you like and just mix it up and have fun with it. What I'm doing now is using a light pink acrylic paint and just making little pink blobs on the nails that I've painted yellow. Of course, you can do more than two, less than two. It's really up to you. Just have fun with it. There's no right way of doing this. Acrylic paints are great to use when you're doing nail art because if you do make a mistake and it's still wet, you can just wipe it right off with water, or if it has dried, you can use a little bit of rubbing alcohol. Wipe it off and it won't ruin the polish underneath, which is great because there will be no more taking off all the polish and starting from the beginning, which I've done a million times and is very frustrating. So it's really great to use acrylic paints and they're super affordable. I think the colors I used in this video were only 50 cents a piece from the craft warehouse, but you can find them just about anywhere at Michael's, Walmart, and they have a ton of different colors. So you can get so many of them for a very small amount of money and they will last you forever. So if you'd like a list of the products and the colors that I've used, I'll make sure that I put all that information in the down bar for you. So now that the light pink has dried, we're going to go in with a darker pink, brighter pink, and make the outline and sort of the petals on the inside. So what I like to do is make three separate lines going around the outside of the light pink. I don't connect them. I like to make them separate so that the whole thing isn't outlined, but you can do it any way that you like. And then I put a dot in the center to be the center of the rose, and then I just sort of make random sort of half circles going around the inside to make the petals. And it's kind of hard to explain, but hopefully you can see what I'm doing and just know that it's very easy and this can all be done in a very short amount of time. It's very fast and very easy. So actually the less perfect it is, the better, because it's going to look more like a flower in the end if it's sort of squiggly and a little bit messy. So just give it a try and I'm sure it will turn out great. She read me the note and left on her bed, stuck in her room right after she left, and put petals on the ground, her head on her shoulder. Down the hall, I'm left to wonder, will I ever fall in love? And where is he now? She's with him, I'm in the backseat. No, it's not right, but it hurts when they're laughing. I've never been where they are. I wanna be now I'm going in with a light green paint and just making little leaves on my flowers. And I actually didn't have a light green, so I used a darker green and a white, mixed them together and came up with this color. But really you can use any color of green that you like and just make little tiny leaves coming out of the sides of the flowers. You can do one on each flower, one on each side. You can group two together. Again, there's no right way of doing it. It's all up to you and how you like it. As he turns to her and smiles, Again, I'm taking a white acrylic paint and actually the end of a bobby pin because for some reason I don't have a dotting tool. But you can use a toothpick, a pen, anything with a pointy tip, and just make polka dots on the nails that you didn't put the flowers on. Now that we're all finished with the design and it's dried, I'm going to go ahead and finish this off with a top coat, and I will have a picture of the finished nails at the end and also a picture of the products that I used, and a list of those products will be in the down bar. So thank you for watching, and I hope all of you that celebrate Easter have a very happy Easter, and those who don't, happy Sunday!